With great power comes great responsibility. And today I want to talk about the great responsibility of being an authority within your industry. And we want to go even deeper than that. I want to show you and break down the blueprint to you becoming an authority in your industry. We're going to get into it on this episode. I'm going to give you 5 steps to become an authority in your industry. Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. What's going on, family? Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show, and I'm your host, Jonathan Jones. Glad to be here, glad to hang out with you, and most importantly, excited to give you this content. All right, one thing that I've realized just over my 6 years of doing business is just knowing that everybody wants to be number one. Everybody wants to be the authority. Everybody wants to be the top dog, because the individual who's the top dog typically is on the stages with the bright lights and they have the microphone. They're the ones people point to and say, I want to be like her. I want to be like him. But the craziest thing is, in order to get to that spot, in order to get to that place, to have that level of authority, you got to do some work. You got to do some work. So before we even get to the part of the work, I want to talk just for a second and define the word authority. According to Merriam-Webster, the second definition of authority is the confident quality of someone who knows a lot about something or who is respected or obeyed by other people. Let's break it down. The confident quality of someone who knows a lot. If you know a lot, that means you studied, that means you've read, that means you have experience, right? If you know a lot about something, that means you've done that level of work and you're continuing to do it. Or if you're respected, then this just means over time, you have a body of work to where people can refer back to content. People can say, oh, check out this video. Check out that podcast. Read this article, right? So that's somebody who is an authority. So finding out the best way or the blueprint to truly become an authority, let's go ahead and kick this thing off. The first thing that you have to do is understand that this is not going to be everybody's recipe. Our philosophy for becoming an authority. This is me saying this, and this is me based on what I've done from experience. So if this ultimately combats somebody else's definition or somebody else's philosophy, good. Then I would say compare the two, see what works for you, eat the meat, throw away the bones. First things first is, in your industry, you have to find out where the people within your industry hang out. Let's say that you're somebody who's a sneakerhead. You need to find out what are the forums online where sneakerheads are communing. Where's the places where sneakerheads are connecting? What conferences are sneakerheads at? You want to first find this so you can begin to see what they're talking about. You can have your quote unquote ear to the street, right? Because if you know what people are talking about, then you know what the main pain point is for many people. For instance, if we talk about podcasting, one of the biggest pain points with podcasters is they want to grow their listenership. And that's why I did an episode a little while ago talking about ways that you can grow your listenership and then also ways that you can identify your niche, right? So you want to know where the people in your industry, the thought leaders in your industry, are hanging out, because you want to get some information. So that's the first thing. We have to find where they hang out so we can have our ear to the street. And then when you do that, then you want to begin to befriend them. You want to begin to befriend people in your industry. Why do I want to begin to befriend people in my industry, John? The reason is this. When you begin to get closer and connected with people in the industry, now they're challenging you to level up. They're challenging and forcing you to grow. Because if you're in an industry with people that are constantly learning about the sneakerhead industry, I'll just stay with that example, then you're going to need to learn more. so that you can have conversations, so that you can look educated and intellectual when you all begin to have debates about which shoe is better, the Jordan Retro 1 or the Jordan 12s, right? These are just conversations that people will begin to have, but you have to be in spaces to have the conversations with people. And for those of you who may not know, the Retro Jordan 1 and the Jordan 12, those, that was a shoe reference to a Michael Jordan shoe. Just FYI, all right? Don't want to lose nobody. Don't want to lose nobody. So after we do those two things, then what we want to do is we want to do informational interviews of them, or we want to poll them, right? We want to approach them. We want to see what's a problem that you're having right now finding sneakers. What's a problem that you're having right now in the sneaker industry? Is it trying to sell the shoes? Is it trying to find a way to where you can ship the shoes for cheaper? Is it you finding a place to where you can get multiples of the shoes, right? You want to talk to them and see what's the problem in the industry. What's a problem that you're facing, Johnny? What's a problem that you're facing, Jane? What's a problem that you're facing, Toby? And when we begin to see repetition of the problem, of the issue, of what's happening in the industry, then this is when we really get to work. Because the beautiful thing about this is you don't have to have the answer to the problem right now. You're listening. You're doing market research. You're taking the time to learn, taking the time to listen, taking the time to really take a step back and say, okay, I'm jotting this down. I'm taking this note. I'm taking that note. Because the more notes you take, the more intentional you are, the more Zoom calls you sit on with people, the more informational interviews you do, the more polls that you do, then you'll be able to create content answering the common questions as they apply in your respective industry. Once again, we're focusing on how can we become an authority in our specific industry, right? So we want to answer the questions and we want to solve the problems that apply to our specific industry. And I'm going to take a slight pause right here and just let you all know that if you are a coach, you're a speaker, you're a consultant, and you're saying that you here in this episode and you want to be an authority, well, I want to invite you to our free training that we have coming up, and you can just go to yourpodcastmentorshow.com, and then at the top, you'll see a tab that says a free webinar or free training. Click that and just register. In that training, I'm going to show you how you can leverage a podcast to become an authority, right? To help you explode your leads. And in addition to that, help you generate revenue, even if you have a small audience. All right. So go to yourpodcastmentorshow.com and get registered for the free training. I'll see you there. Okay. Now back to the episode. So as you began to create that content and as you began to answer the common questions as they apply to your industry, one, you're going to be able to see some themes, right? Two, you're going to also begin to see the gaps. So you're going to begin to see the areas that people are not addressing. When you start to see the FAQs or the frequently asked questions, you're going to realize that there are some people that just aren't answering these questions. So that gives you an opportunity for you to now answer questions. And then as you began to answer these questions, as you began to share this content, the next point I want you to take into mind is I want you to now become omnipresent. I want you to create omnipresence. All right. And omnipresence basically is making you be everywhere at once, right? Wide or constantly encountered, common or widespread is the definition of omnipresent. Widely or constantly encountered, common or widespread. I just want to let you all know that I'm reading these definitions off Google. I do not know these definitions off the top of my head, all right? And when I say create omnipresence, you want to position your content wherever you know these people will look, right? If you know your audience typically wants to go to Instagram, post it on Instagram. If you know they're more of the YouTube crew, post it on YouTube. If you know that they really like to get down in the Twitter threads and in the Twitter chat, do it on Twitter. But I want you to be omnipresent, because at the end of the day, when somebody is looking for a solution to a problem and it's keeping them up late at night, you want to make sure that you're wherever they look. And when you're wherever they look, you want to, just like I said, be posting in the social groups, like on Facebook, and put out blogs, release a podcast focusing on whatever that pain point is in that industry. And then come in close for this final point. Come in close. Yeah. You want to be so versed in your topic that you go an inch forward in a mile deep within that industry. One more time. You want to go an inch forward in a mile deep. What am I saying? A lot of times when we start to see a little bit of success, then we want to start doing something else. And then we lose focus of the main thing, the main purpose, the main goal. I want your main goal to become an authority in 2022. And then I want you to hammer and hammer and hammer and axe and claw and chop till the tree falls down. Then I want you to chop the tree up into lumber. Then I want you to chop it up into little wood bits to do barbecues, and then chop that lumber up and then burn it on a fireplace, and then take those ashes and then use it for fertilizer. I want you to grain every grit down possible in your industry so that you will be undisputedly an authority. Let's go ahead and recap these points. Y'all got a little fired up right here. Because I want you to realize that it's easy to be the authority. Let me rephrase that. It's simple to be the authority. It's not easy. I've said it once. I'm going to say it again. I'm going to make sure I link it down in the show notes. I'm challenging myself in 2022 to upload a YouTube short video a day for every day in 2022. Every single day, I'm going to do either podcast news or I'm going to do a quick podcast how-to as a YouTube short every single day this year. And I'm going to do that because I am forcing my hand to establish myself as an authority in the podcast industry. I know that there are many other people that have many more years experience than I, and that's okay. But once I go through this process, your boy is going to be searchable with the SEO. Your boy is going to be searchable. And you're going to see me solve every podcast problem that comes up one by one by one by one. If people are talking about it for a couple of days, I want people to talk about it in a day and then I hop on it. So let me recap these points. And I'm sharing this with you. I'm sharing my philosophy with you all and my strategy with you all, because you can take the same strategy in your industry and make it apply and make it work for you. Shout out to Tanner Campbell. He is the host of Podcasting Sucks. And Tanner does a podcast every single day of the week. No, there's no excuse at this point. He's been crowned the number one podcast on the Good Pods app because he's gone at it day after day after day after day. Tanner's an authority. Period. At Tanner Helps. This is his handle on Twitter. Okay, so look, we're going to go ahead and do the recap. But one more time, I just want to let you all know, if you are a speaker, a coach, or a consultant, make sure that you sign up for this free training. It's going to bless you. I promise. Okay, I promise. But you can go to yourpodcastmentorshow.com, and at the top of the page, you will see a link or a tab that says free webinar or free training. And you want to click that and then go ahead and get signed up, because I'm going to show you how to become an authority and leverage podcasting. Even if you have small leads still helping you generate revenue, even if you have no exposure in the past, I'm going to show you how to use podcasting to explode your leads, generate that revenue, and really force your hand to establish all the authority in the market. Here's the recap for what we talked about today, family. The focus was finding, well, how to be an authority in your industry. The first thing I talked about, I said, first you have to find out where your people hang out at for your industry. Where do they hang out at? You have to find them, because if you don't find them, then you're not going to get the right information. That was number one. Number two is you want to befriend them. Get connected with them. Make relationships with these individuals in the industry, because it's going to challenge you to level up. Then you want to do informational interviews. Find out what they're watching. Find out what they're listening to. Find out where they get their information from. After you do that, then you want to take the time, and then you want to create content answering the common questions that they've been facing, answering the common problems that typically come up over and over and over and over again, right? Because once we begin to do that, then that positions us really, really strong. And then you want to create a sense of omnipresence. If you're everywhere, how can people not see you? One more time. If you're everywhere, how can people not see you? They have to see you. They have to acknowledge you. And they have to respect you. Remember, the definition, the definition of authority is the confident quality of someone who knows a lot about something or who is respected or obeyed by others. Who knows a lot about something or who is respected or obeyed by others. Are you authority in your industry? If you're watching on YouTube, comment down below. What industry are you an authority in? Just comment down below. Let's have a chat. But family, we're going to go ahead and get out of here. I want to let you all know that I appreciate the reviews that are coming in. I appreciate the comments and the support. You all are too kind. And if you have a question and you want to submit a question to the show and you want me to answer it live on air, just go to the website, yourpodcastmentorshow.com, which is going to be down in the show notes, and then click the microphone to the bottom right-hand corner when you go on the website. And then say your name, say your podcast, say your Instagram handle, and then ask your question. And then I'll definitely answer that and show you love in that way. And please, whatever platform you listen on, feel free to rate, feel free to review, and let us know how we can grow. Let us know how we can get better, and let us know how we can further serve you. It's your podcast mentor, Jonathan Jones, and we're about to get out of here. And remember, the focus and the premise of this show is ultimately to bring to you the latest in podcast news and podcasting how-tos, showing you how you can ultimately establish your platform so that you can profit on purpose from your podcast. Peace and God bless.